Gaming Vault presents 20 games of 2017 that will give you more than 100 hours of gameplay. We've got a lot to cover here, so let's dive in right away. Red Dead Redemption 2. It has been a long time since Red Dead Redemption first graced our screens, but in 2017 the game will finally return. Not much is known at this point, but it's likely that the open-world sandbox will be even bigger than the last game. And if recent entries in the Grand Theft Auto line are any indication, there will be a great deal for players to do both in the core game and with the aid of their own creations. This game will also feature multiplayer, so it's likely you'll have even more to do once your friends get into the game. Horizon Zero Dawn. Horizon Zero Dawn is a new IP from Guerrilla Games, featuring a massive open world and giant robot dinosaurs. From the gameplay we've seen, combat seems deep and complex, with a balance of timing, skill, and choosing the right weapon for the right moment. The game will also feature a crafting system, which will encourage players to explore the massive, rich environments of the game world. Mass Effect Andromeda. The Mass Effect games have always been big. Quick playthroughs of the original trilogy could be completed relatively quickly, but to really engage with the game meant that completing the main story could take anywhere from 20 to 40 hours. When you couple the sheer length of the game with any gamer's need to play back through, making different choices, you'll hit hundreds of hours of gameplay in no time. Multiplayer is also making a comeback in Andromeda and will reportedly build on the lessons learned in Mass Effect 3. I still play Mass Effect 3 multiplayer with my friends, and I'm sure Andromeda is going to give us dozens of more hours of entertainment. Destiny 2. Almost nothing is known about Destiny 2 at this point, except that it's coming. Destiny has been plagued throughout its life by accusations of not having enough content, but even in such an emaciated state, Destiny is a massive game with a huge variety of activities and rewards to seek. If Destiny 2 is the same size, it'll be easy to sink a few more hundred hours into it. If it's bigger, then we'll just have to sink in that much more. Tom Clancy's Ghost Recon Wildlands. Wildlands is a cooperative open-world game, where you and your teammates will roam the Bolivian highlands as you try to take on the Santa Blanca cartel. The game's developers have emphasized that the game will allow for multiple approaches to each encounter, which will allow players to play through the game many times, experimenting with different tactics, roles, and strategies as they work to take out the cartel. Endless Space 2. Endless Space 2 is a 4X strategy game where players control a civilization as it takes its first steps into the stellar void. Like any grand strategy game, Endless Space will take time to get through, with games likely ranging from a few hours to dozens. Like Civ or Stellaris, Endless Space 2 will be a slow-burning game, one you can enjoy over long periods of time, during which the process of playing brings as much joy as the thrill of victory. It won't take many games before the number under play on Steam reaches 100. Mount & Blade 2 – Bannerlord. Mount & Blade is a curious fusion of action RPG and nation builders. Like a true feudal lord, you are responsible both for leading your armies, navigating court society, and running your kingdom, be it a village or an empire. Hopefully, Bannerlord will streamline some of the game's early stages, making the game a little more accessible than the original. But even if they didn't, Mount & Blade offers an incredibly deep world in which to craft your own feudal narrative. And that's before you go online and hack at your fellow players with a sword. Dawn of War 3. The Dawn of War series was crucial when I was a kid. It provided the science fiction RTS stopgap between Brood Wars and StarCraft II, and it brought the tabletop world of Warhammer 40K to life on the computer. Now, Dawn of War is returning on a grand scale, with Imperial Knights at the head of massed Space Marine deployments. The game will feature a campaign that players will definitely sink hours into, but its multiplayer games will keep players coming back over and over. Halo Wars 2. Like Dawn of War, any RTS warrants game after game, each match unique thanks to the quirks of your opponents. Halo Wars 2 will feature a campaign and a new villain, the Brute Warlord Atriox, and numerous different game modes like a controversial Blitz and Firefight. For competitive players, the game will offer an RTS's usual fare, but the game will also feature co-op modes against waves of AI, which will offer hours of gameplay for gamers who might not typically be drawn to an RTS title. LEGO Worlds. If Minecraft has been any indication, giving players a digital space in which to build anything they want is a good way to hook people. Add the power of LEGO to that formula and you've easily got a hugely appealing game. LEGO Worlds will also feature multiplayer, allowing you to join your friends and build a shared space to your heart's content. Sea of Thieves. Sea of Thieves is a shared open-world game about crewing a pirate ship, finding buried treasure, and getting that treasure to a safe haven. Along the way, you might be boarded by rival pirates or even betrayed by your own crew. Sea of Thieves iterates on a simple premise, allowing the shared world to shape players' experiences more deeply. Will you form a pirate fleet, set out on your own, defend the safe harbor, and sink any ship that approaches? The choices are yours, and the opportunities for emergent gameplay ensures that you'll have novel experiences every time you log in. For Honor. While it may not be everyone's cup of tea, For Honor promises to be an incredibly deep experience. The combat system for the game is based on reading your opponent's angle of attack, as well as the power, speed, and range of their possible attacks determined by their class. It looks like a game that will have an incredibly high skill ceiling. For Honor will feature a campaign, but the clear draws of the game is multiplayer, and the chance to pit your blade against a living, dangerous opponent. Persona 5. In Persona 5, players take the role of a silent protagonist, transferred to a new high school after being placed on probation for assault. There, they awaken their psychic powers and become vigilantes with their friends, dividing their time between school and the exploration of supernatural dungeons. The game was released in Japan in 2016, but is set to come to North America in 2017, and reports are that a single playthrough of the game borders on 100 hours. The Legend of Zelda: Breath of the Wild. The next entry into the Zelda franchise boasts the largest map in the series' history, and is reportedly 12 times the size of Twilight Princess. If map size correlates to volume of content, Breath of the Wild is set to be a massive game, easily warranting 100 hours of exploration, survival, and combat. Divinity: Original Sin 2. Divinity: Original Sin 2 is what you get when you take a pen and paper RPG and cram it into a computer game. The game features tactical, turn-based combat that will give you unprecedented control over your character's powers as you delve deep into the world's dungeons. It also features a wide array of choices. You can fight anyone, destroy environmental assets, speak to animals, and use the game's systems to open up whole portions of the game that might remain hidden without your character's specific skill set. The game is sure to provide many hours of exploratory fun even before you start in on the multiplayer. Nioh. Nioh is the story of William, a Western sailor recruited to help vanquish demons in a fictional version of Japan's bloody Sengoku period. In Nioh, players make use of a wide variety of weapons, as well as different armor sets that determine agility. Combat in the game seems punishing, demanding that players approach it with caution. Death is guaranteed, and players will likely need to experiment with what tactics are appropriate at what times. As reviews filter in, the game is also massive and will keep players occupied for a while. Ni no Kuni 2. In Ni no Kuni 2, players take on the role of Evan, a boy king ousted by a hostile coup. Players must rally his supporters, retake his kingdom, and save the world from encroaching darkness. Not much is known at present, but a thorough playthrough of Ni no Kuni: Wrath of the Witch would take up to 90 hours. If the trend of games to get even bigger with each iteration continues, then Ni no Kuni 2 will surely break 100 hours. Detroit: Become Human. The trailer of Detroit: Become Human shows off the game's branching story. In just the few moments of the rooftop encounter, we see myriad futures play out. Not much about the game is known at present, but the allure of branching storylines is obvious, and players who enjoy one playthrough of the game will likely enjoy many as they alter their decisions and watch their effects cascade through the rest of the story. Star Trek: Bridge Crew. Star Trek: Bridge Crew is a forthcoming co-op VR game that puts players on the bridge of the Starship Enterprise. Players will have to work together to manage the ship's many systems, just like the bridge crew does in the shows and movies. For fans of the series, it's a dream come true, and the gameplay possibilities are as endless as the shows. Trekkies will no doubt love the experience, and the devs have the opportunity to develop dozens of scenarios to test players' cooperative puzzle-solving skills. Elix. Elix is an upcoming open-world sci-fi fantasy RPG. In the game, you'll inhabit a post-apocalyptic, semi-magical world where your choices have real consequence. Integrated quest chains with moral choices will shape the world that players create, meaning that each playthrough offers the opportunity for a radically different outcome. On top of this, Elix will feature jetpacks that allow you to reach any part of the map, giving players unprecedented levels of freedom in exploration. And that'll be about it for this one. If you guys like what we're doing at Gaming Vault, please consider subscribing to our channel, and I'll see you guys on the next video.